children, how are you? I'm Parveen Sultana, PhD Physical Science, TSWRS Nakrekal. Today I'm going to teach you about motion and time. Now look at this picture.
We observe many things moving around us, like birds in the air, flying in the air, aeroplanes flying in the sky, buses, autos, two-wheelers, trucks moving on the road, trains moving on the railway tracks, children playing in the playgrounds, bullock carts moving on the roads, etc.
Similarly, we observe certain things like buildings, trees, etc., electric poles, they will be at rest. Now look at this one here, there is a board. The board is at rest. You can see the flower vases and the toy cars. They are at rest. Now suppose that. Now in the case one, blue car and red car, they are at rest. Now this red car is moving. Now what change did you observe here? There is no change in the position of the blue car, whereas the red car has changed its position from here to here. This means that this red car has been displaced. It has changed its position. We call this red car is in motion. Now, what is this rest and motion? How do we define this rest and motion? A body is said to be at rest if it does not change its position with respect to time. On other hand, a body is said to be in motion. Earlier, the red car was here. Now, it has changed its position. There is a change in position of the car. We say that this is in motion. So, a body is said to be in motion if there is a change in its position with respect to time. So, motion is a body is said to be in motion if its position changes with respect to time. Example for this, motion of the vehicles on the roads, birds flying in the air, etc. Rest. A body is said to be at rest if its position does not change with respect to time. Like a tree, a building, here, the toy car, flower vase, table, board, etc. My position is also at rest. Now, I'm moving. I'm in motion. Look at this picture, children. The man in the boat is moving with respect to the bank of the river and he is at rest with respect to the boat. Here, the same man is moving with respect to one set of surroundings and he is at rest with another set of surroundings. So, we can say a body may be at rest with respect to one set of surroundings and at the same time be in motion with respect to another set of surroundings. So, motion is relative to the observer and the object that is being observed.
Today's homework, we can see in the picture a girl is riding a bicycle. The girl on the bicycle is dashed with respect to the road. She is dashed with respect to the bicycle. Here you can see a girl on a swing. The girl on the swing is dashed with respect to the seat of the swing. She is dashed with respect to the garden. Thank you.